I get at least two or three emails per day asking me what I think about certain diets and whether I think they'll work and what the effects can be on them, what side effects can be. And I think it's important to point out that the diets that I'm being asked about are not new diets. They're new names to diets, but they're diets that have been around for the last 40 years and repackaged and rebooted with some kind of fancy name or some kind of big corporate push behind it to make it seem like something new. There are only 9 diets since the dawn of getting in shape, which are high protein, medium protein, low protein, high carb, medium carb, low carb, and high fat, medium fat, low fat. Everything else is just a variation of those 9 diets. Now, which one will work for you depends on the person. So, you know, what's worked for one person is not going to work for another person. You know, and I'm seeing a lot of like this rebooting and becoming super popular. And I don't understand, because the diets were there all along. Why now, all of a sudden, are these quote-unquote diets becoming popular? One of them is the carb backloading diet. Now, granted, you know, people that do the carb backloading are going to say, oh, it's different than this, it's different than that. It's a little tweak to an old version of a diet, okay? They came out with the Warrior diet, which is essentially you didn't eat all day long, so you fasted all day long, and then you ate all your calories within like a 3-hour span or 2-hour span at night. Now, the hunter-gatherer diet was similar to that, too. And the idea is, if you were a caveman, you would be out there all day long, hunting food, killing it. So you're out there moving around, you're active, picking berries, picking leaves, sticks, whatever else they would eat. Then they would bring it all back to the village, prepare it all, and eat all of it. So that's the idea. You're out fasting, hunting, then you come home and eat. Now, the carb backloading, which is kind of similar, you don't have a whole lot of carbohydrates during the day, which depletes you. You know, you have your proteins, but it depletes you. And I'm not sure if you guys remember this early 80s, mid 80s fad diet that is still around today, that if you look at the basic principles, are the carb backloading. It's called Slim Fast. Shake in the morning, shake in the afternoon, sensible dinner. Now, it's the same principle. They're depleting you throughout the day by having this shake, which is like a low-calorie shake, and you're supposed to have a sensible dinner. Same thing as a carb backloading. You deplete yourself during the day, and then you load up at night. Same principles. The principles have been there for a long time. The difference is someone just sat down and started to piece things together and do a little bit different way and apply it in a different way. So what I'm seeing is these reboots that people think are these new diets. I mean, the Zone diet, I mean, they've all been done before. Dan Duchesne came out with a diet called the isocaloric diet, which was if you had 200 grams of protein and 200 grams of carbs, you had 100 grams of fat. So calorie-wise, it was equal with all 3 macronutrients. They have depletion diets. They have high-fat, low-fat. I mean, Atkins came out with his, you know, high-fat, low-carbohydrate diet. And then Mauro Di Pasquale came out with his anabolic diet, and now his metabolic diet, which is now like a rebooted version of that with a carb up aspect to it that is more geared towards athletes. So again, you see these diets, they're not anything new. They've been happening for the last 40 years and they've been rebooted. So, I mean, look at EAS. When Bill Phillips came out with EAS, he had the Myoplex supplement, and then he basically rebooted the Slim Fast diet, which was having your meal replacements or shakes during the day, and then he would have, you know, pizza or a burger or whatever at night, because his body was nourished, but the calories were very low throughout the day because he was drinking these Myoplex shakes. And he stayed in shape. His brother Sean Phillips stayed in shape. You know, it was just a matter of how they applied the Slim Fast principles to their product. They even came out with some bars and stuff, whatever. But you see what I'm saying? So there's nothing new, folks. If you have a question, part of the problem that I'm getting is I keep getting the same questions over and over again. And that's why I'm doing these videos, to let people, more than one person at a time, know these facts and this information, because I'm finding people just don't take the time themselves to go and do the research. I mean, there's a lot of research on the internet now. You know, back in the day, we didn't have the internet, so it was harder to find these things out. You had to know someone who could explain them to you. But, you know, Google's a wonderful thing. You can find anything in Google within a matter of seconds. So if you have a question, before you start looking for some kind of great new explanation for it, do the research. You know, type in Google and find out how these diets are being rebooted and how they work, so that you're not confused with some kind of sales pitch where someone's just trying to grab your money. Good luck.